Hello, how are you? My name is Alejandro Sandoval, and this is the Solo Negocios video blog with the summary of the Solo Negocios bulletin for today, June the 22nd, 2018. Today, the Mexican peso got appreciated given the following elements, and specifically one of them, which was of high impact. This appreciation is the fifth in 5 days altogether, and so it's in a row, a very good week for the Mexican peso. The oil got up strongly given the OPEC agreement to begin eliminating the cut production agreement that they made in November 2016 and was extended during the whole time until today. OPEC agreed to increase their production in 1 million barrels per day when they said that they was expecting, it was expected to go to 1.5 million barrels. Now, the issue here is that many of the countries belonging to OPEC will not be able to meet this increase in their production. And specifically Iran, that is sanctioned by the US due to the nuclear issues, well, and Venezuela to the political issues, they will not be able to meet the production goals nowadays set by OPEC. And this mix, where there's an agreement but potential not to be met, then the issue here at hand is basically that the price will keep going up. That's the interpretation of the market, and that's why the reaction of the whole markets at the world in terms of oil. Now, also, there's a Bloomberg dollar spot index going down 0.36%, where Forex markets rose positions in pesos due to lower demand for safe harbor assets. Basically, there's a less risk aversion today. USA got information on their PMI for the manufacturing sector. It was better than expected. And on the PMI for services, it was the same as expected. NAFTA, there's alleged support from Trump, given a tweet that he made today, but he noticed differences in migration issues, specifically with Mexico, but also Canada. INEGI, Mexican statistics entity, reported inflation for the first 15 days for June, and it went down when it was expected to go up. It was 4.54% in annual terms, and this implies that there's no infection from the depreciation of the peso from the last 2 months to the inflation element. So this plus yesterday's decision of Banco de Mexico to increase their rate brings some strong support for the Mexican peso and potential appreciation in the following days. Also, in Banco de Mexico, there was an increase of the exchange rate's volatility with 5.12 times which the amount demanded for against the amount offered. And this is for 60 days. This is basically a little increase in the volatility for this element. But even with that element, which is kind of negative for the Mexican peso, the rest of elements supported the Mexican peso, but specifically the OPEC one. Now, I'm going to talk about specifically this agreement. OPEC, as I told you, they made this agreement to cut production and increase the price back in November 2016, given that there was an excedent of the production of the offer of oil and the price was too low. It was even by February 2016 around $25 per barrel for the West Texas Intermediate. And now, given that agreement to cut production during 2017, basically, the price went up to today, more or less around the $60 per barrel, $70 per barrel, even $80 per barrel in some references. The issue here basically is that they will plan to increase 1 million barrels per day, but not everyone will be able to meet the agreement. And also, for example, Japan, who purchases oil from Iran in certain proportion, well, the USA is negotiating with them to avoid it, because these sanctions against Iran basically could not be met if it's only the US who sanctions them. They have to negotiate with the European Union and with other countries like Japan, also China maybe. But now with the trade war, there won't be much of a nice position to do so. So we will be seeing how they react. But in general terms, this mixture between OPEC agreement to increase production in 1 million barrels per day, and the issue that it won't be met because some of their countries, between some of them, Iran, Venezuela, and other ones, will not be able to increase their production either for sanctions or for the capacity of production. Well, basically, this implies a potential growth for the following months in the market of oil. And expectations met by the whole entities of analysis and in different parts of the world are saying that potentially we'll be seeing $100 per barrel for the following year, which in terms of Mexican budget is a good element, because more dollars can be entering into Mexico given the sales of oil. And besides that, the other part of the story will be that increases in other elements like gasoline because of the increase in oil price. We will see what happens, but we'll see you next Monday. Thank you very much for your attention.